In this short video, we will highlight the key differences between centralized wallets like the crypto.com app and exchange and decentralized wallets like the crypto.com DeFi Wallet app. Let's get started. The crypto.com app and exchange are centralized wallets, which means that crypto.com acts as the wallet custodian and stores your crypto assets on your behalf. To open an account on crypto.com, you first need to verify your identity and perform KYC. Should you ever forget your password, crypto.com's support team is able to help you retrieve it. Transactions made with the crypto.com app or exchange wallet are processed almost instantly with the crypto.com ecosystem with zero network fees. On the other hand, decentralized wallets like the crypto.com DeFi Wallet app are non-custodial. Simply put, the crypto.com DeFi Wallet app is an interface with an easy UI enabling you to create and import wallets, as well as display and manage your crypto assets, which are stored on-chain. You have full ownership and control of your crypto. So if you lose your login password, the only way to recover them is to enter your 12-word recovery phrase, which is your private keys. Since no identity proof is required, the risk of data breaches are also lower. You can view your wallet balances on explorers like Etherscan by inputting your wallet address, but your recovery phrase is required to access and spend your crypto assets. All transactions on DeFi Wallet are processed on-chain. Most DeFi protocols or DeFi applications are built on the Ethereum network. To execute and confirm a transaction, you need to pay network fees for the computational effort that's required to validate and confirm the transaction. It is usually paid in the network's native token. For example, the Ethereum network requires ETH to carry out transactions. So you must store ETH in order to send, swap, deposit, and withdraw your ERC-20 tokens. The amount of gas fees depend on the blockchain's consensus mechanism, transfer speed, network traffic, and how complicated the transaction is. Remember, always back up your recovery phrase and keep it safe. In doing so, you'll be able to easily regain access to your crypto assets on any non-custodial wallet. Here's a quick summary of the differences between centralized and decentralized wallets. Thank you for watching. If you're interested to learn more, be sure to join our DeFi Telegram group at crypto.com_DeFi Wallet.